PrivyCeese Group, the world's third largest communications group, has just released its Q1 revenue numbers. I'm here to discuss them now with CEO Maurice Lévy. Mr. Lévy, a pleasure to see you.
Bonjour, it's my pleasure also to see you again.
Now, a lot has changed since we first met. You've just released those Q1 numbers. You've got better than expected organic growth. What would you say are the key highlights, and where did that improved expected performance come from?
First, it's real that our numbers are well above our own expectation. This is due to many factors. The first one is the fact that we won a few accounts at the end of last year that are generating revenue in the Q1. So that's a nice thing to have. So organic growth is at 2.9% thanks to this. Second, we have most of our operations which are doing extremely well. This is the case for Publicis Media, for Publicis Health. And the good news is that Sapient has delivered a higher than 10% organic growth for the first quarter. When you put all this together, you have a number which is up by 8.9% compared to last year. There are also some other good news, particularly the fact that many countries have contributed to the growth. It's the case in Europe with Spain, which is positive, not very much, but positive. Italy, which is back to growth. Germany, with a very nice growth. UK, with a small decline, but stabilizing. And France, with a nice growth. India is very good. China also has delivered good growth. This is the case for the US, for Russia, and for many other countries. The only big concern that we have is the issue of Brazil and some other smallish countries which are showing some decline. This is the case for Mexico, it's the case for a few countries, Israel, Egypt. But all in all, we have a very good Q1.
Okay, well, as you said, of course, an increase in organic growth is encouraging. You caution, though, that you're still expecting modest increases in organic growth for full 2016. Which headwinds do you anticipate will weigh on growth this year?
If you look back at the end of last year, we have been hit by a few losses, and this was the famous Mediapalooza. So we are expecting a headwind of 1.5% for the full year. So if the first quarter has been impacted lightly, we expect that the second and the third quarter will be more impacted than the first. All in all, we are still expecting a pretty good year in total, with a nice increase of all our financial indicators, starting obviously with the revenues, but also with earnings per share, as well as the net profit.
Now, a lot of outside factors, of course, can have an impact on results. What's your outlook today on the global economy and its impact on your business? Do you think that events like the Olympics and the U.S. presidential elections could have an impact on the business?
U.S. presidential election has no impact for us. It has a nice impact for the media because they are using a lot of media, and this is good for the media because they are selling a lot of ads. But we, the advertising agencies, and particularly we, publicists, we don't work for any political party. So therefore, this has zero impact on our numbers. Regarding the Olympic Games, normally these represent roughly 100 basis points of growth. Sometimes people expect it to be 120. But as this is happening in Brazil, I'm afraid that we should have something which is below what we are getting in normal days.
Last year, of course, you announced a major reorganization, and a lot is riding on the successful completion of that plan, including, of course, achieving higher organic growth. How is that organization progressing, and how are your clients reacting?
We are transforming ourselves in a way which has never been seen before in the advertising world. It is a true transformation of our business. This is due to the fact that The digitization of the world has a huge impact on our clients. They need to transform themselves, and in order to best serve them, we need to transform ourselves. This is what we are doing. By the way, something which is extremely important is that we have 55% of our revenue which is now derived from digital. So we had to change the way we are operating. There is no longer a holding company. We are an operating company, a connecting company, which is using all its assets at the service of our client, with four major solution hubs and Publicis One for the smaller countries. All the implementation is doing extremely well, and we are perfectly on timing. It is a mystery how this has worked well, and there is very few things that we have to do. And as we indicated already, everything will be up and running by the end of June. In the meantime, we have already presented our solutions and our new organization to our client. The results are tremendous. They are all very excited because we are the only one to offer today an end-to-end solution which is encompassing from consulting to the deployment of the ads through the whole creative process. So be it on technology or be it just on offline, we are offering an end-to-end solution to our client, and they love it.
So the returns have been quite positive then?
So far, yes, and we expect that this will drive a lot of growth, and will, more importantly than driving growth, it will help us to become the best partner for our client, helping them to move to the next level.
You mentioned the number of 55% of revenue now in digital. When do you expect organic growth will return then to sector average?
So we have a growth in the first quarter on digital, which is 7.6% organic growth with 55% of our revenue. This shows clearly that the 45% has a negative impact. So we are continuing to drive more digital operations in order to increase our digital contribution to the whole growth. We expect that in 2017, not only we will be aligned with our competitors, but we will certainly surpass most of them.
Maurice Lévy, thank you very much.
Thank you.